A warm welcome to InBody's webinar on corporate job and health management. My name is Ankita Ghaga. I am a clinical dietitian with InBody India. Today I will be taking you throughout this webinar. Let's understand what is a corporate job. There is no specific definition for a corporate job, but this kind of a job is a stable business. When we talk about the corporate jobs or corporate life, what are we talking about? People running round the clock for their meetings or for some other kind of activity related to their business. What is the complementary thing which they get in this corporate life? Smoking habit, eating what not, and drinking habit. Is it good? People are constantly on a run when it comes to a corporate life. Even at night, they are on their laptops, they are working some other thing. What is it leading to? Disturbed sleep patterns. The perks which they are getting is stress. Lifestyle disorders because of constant smoking, alcohol and unexpected parties which are taking place. There are constant mood swings in these individuals because of which there is absenteeism. There is no balance between the work life, personal life. So these are the perks which they are getting by not following the healthier lifestyle. What is the solution for this? The solution is there should be a balance, proper integration between the personal life and professional life, wherein family, communication, work, career and health and well-being should be taken care of. There should be work-life integration which should be taken care. Today we will be talking about well-being and health in much more details. What are the ill effects when we don't balance this lifestyle? Firstly, there is excessive eating and addictions like tobacco chewing or tobacco smoking, alcohol or whatnot. There is a reduced physical activity because people say, I don't have time because I have to work so much. And sleep duration because of increased screen timing has been reduced. People drink 8 to 10 cups of coffee in a day's time or lots of tea in their diet. And where does it lead to? It is leading towards an obesity. And obesity is a root cause of various metabolic disorders. Let's talk about the sleep. There was a study which was done for 6 years which stated people who are having short sleeping duration and longer sleeping duration are more prone for gaining body weight and body fat. So adequate amount of sleep is essential. Excessive weight gain and obesity are the byproducts of this inadequate sleep timings. After knowing adequate amount of sleep is essential, next question comes to our mind, how much should I sleep? There was a study done which states people who slept for 6 to 6 and a half hours regained their body fat very easily, and whatever they lost, 58% was fat and 39% was their lean muscles. And gaining muscles takes lots of time, but losing it just very easy. As compared to the people who followed a proper diet and exercise and slept for 7 to 7 and a half hours, they lost 83% of their body fat on whatever they lost their weight and 17% of their muscles. Therefore, it states that sleep is very essential for our day-to-day living. Adequate amount of sleep, that is in between 6 to 8 hours, is essential. After sleep, the most important thing which happens in a corporate life is the smoking. There is constant smoke breaks which people take. And what is smoking leading to? It is leading to increased abdominal and visceral fat. There was a study which was done which stated cigarette smoking is a major underlying cause of gaining more amount of body fat. The results were the heavy smokers were having higher amount of body fat and visceral fat as compared to the one who were the non-smokers or light smokers. And their BMI was never into a consideration because BMI remained the same but the composition changed. What they concluded that cessation of smoking was very essential to prevent from obesity and complications related to obesity such as diabetes, hypertension and many more. After smoking, the most common lifestyle which we will see is alcohol consumption. When we talk about alcohol, just remember one thing. Apart from obesity, It will also help to damage the heart, kidneys, liver and brain. So whenever now you think about alcohol, just remember these four organs and understand how essential these organs are. If alcohol intake is not being ceased, then it can lead to various metabolic disorders, including heart failures, because it increases your body fat and your visceral fat. So it's very essential to cut down on alcohol. Talking about the fat, we also need to know if there is excessive fatty intake, the body is depleting the muscles. The muscles are equally affected. So when there is excessive fat intake, it is leading to a condition which is known as lipotoxicity. In lipotoxicity, there are various fatty acids which are getting deposited inside the places where it shouldn't be. For example, it is getting deposited inside your muscles, leading to a condition named as intramuscular fat, which results in insulin resistance. Insulin resistance in a longer run is responsible for biggest metabolic disorder named as diabetes mellitus. And we all know diabetes is like a white termite. Once it enters, it will just become a silent killer and start affecting other organs if not taken care of. And where does it start from? Your lifestyle and sarcopenia. How do we understand the person is having sarcopenia? It's simple, just by understanding their skeletal muscle index. It is nothing but your appendicular skeletal muscle mass, that is your right arm plus left arm, right leg plus left leg, divided by height in meter square. The normal ranges are, it should be 7 kg per meter square for males and 5.7 kg per meter square for females. If it is below, that means the person is sarcopenic. If it is above, that is great. Since we spoke about sarcopenia, there are various other disorders which can be understood just by their body composition. If we see Indian diabetes risk score, with the help of their waist circumference and their activity level, we come to know the person is at risk of diabetes. Same thing happens if we check their visceral fat levels. It will tell us how much person is prone for cardiovascular disorders in a near future. Now, if I see the corporate working and today's scenario, that is COVID-19, there are three tiers which we need to work on. First is social distancing, which can be done much more efficiently at management level. Second is precautionary step, again that is a call on management. Third is immunity, that's where we come into the picture. Body composition, as I said before, plays a major role in terms of understanding how much the person is prone for obesity and complications related to obesity. Nutrition and fitness, it should be implicated on them. Online exercises program is something nowadays people should be encouraged for. A small lifestyle changes and employee wellness activities can be conducted from management level in order to make the person more immune and beat COVID-19. We all know how to overcome it. It is with the help of healthy lifestyle. Now, talking about the healthy lifestyle, it includes your meditation, it includes your sleep, it includes proper eating habits, it also includes monitoring your weight and your body composition. Once you encourage your employees, or once the employee is encouraged for getting into healthier lifestyle, let's get monitoring that healthy lifestyle in a twist. Let's play a challenge wherein it's you versus you. There will be 8-week transformation program which will take place, wherein you need to work up, but work on your own self. Get a better version of yourself out. Once we get into something, there is certain aim and objective in our mind before starting anything. So same happens with the in-body challenge. The aims and objectives are to reduce the absenteeism and presenteeism, lost time and low cost behind this entire program. There will be proper utilization, there will be proper decision making skills and increased productivity, because your body composition is improving. There is less amount of lethargicness present. There is overall improvement in employee morale. there will be reduced turnover of your disorders, and it will help to improve the disease management and prevention. Therefore, it's very essential to have certain objectives in the mind before starting any kind of program, and challenge will help you for the same. Once I spoke about the challenge, the biggest question is how we can do it. Is it really feasible? Can it be done along with my work timing? The answer is yes. It should be started by doing your in-body test first. Once you do your test, you get to know what are your targets. Once you get your target, you start working over it with the help of proper diet, exercise, and adequate sleep. While doing that, you need to record these things. And nowadays, mobiles are very handy. We are more into digitalization. So that's where we can do this. While doing this activity, just click a video or just take a picture of it. It's quite easy. And at the end of the day, it will just take 30 microseconds to send it to your admin. Admin will record it. And then, after 2 weeks, again check your progress. Once you check your progress, it will motivate you. If you are going on the proper side, if you are going on the wrong side, it will also help you to correct your own lifestyle. And then what are you getting? A better version of your own self. Here is a small example of in-body challenge which we did. It was a small experiment just to see whether whatever we are saying is practically feasible or not with our day-to-day lifestyle. So have a look over it.
Let's get fit.
All the very best.
Let's get fit.
Let's get fit together.
Let's do this.
Hold and skipping, jitna kehne mein aasan hota hai, utna karne mein nahi hota hai. Theek hai, lag jaati hai.
How much I can lose.
We understood this challenge is going to take us to healthier lifestyle, but how? What is the major objective of this challenge? The motivation out here is to lose more amount of fat and gain more amount of muscles, because most of the individuals right now are lacking muscles. There was a research which was done way back in 2017 which stated 82% of Indian population is lacking their muscle quality, and we are here to help you improve that. Therefore, it's very essential to take part in certain activities and lose your fat and gain more amount of muscles. You can also promote it saying the biggest fat loser wins. As we all know, Rome wasn't built in one day. Same thing, your body and your transformation won't take place in one day's time. There should be a consistency. For example, here is a sample thing which we have done for 8 weeks, keeping Sunday as a rest day, and Monday to Saturday is 40 minutes exercise daily and some other technique in your diet which will help you to have a proper and healthier lifestyle. Just have a look over it. Now comes the most important thing, how to incorporate in a corporate culture. It's very easy. It can be activity taken care by HR team, which is either a health check program for employees or employee wellness program. wherein employee will do the test, sign up for the 8 week of transformation and monitor their progress. Once it is done and they take pictures and videos on day-to-day basis, they will just simply send it to the HR team. HR team will help to analyze the results and reward the biggest fat loser and motivate others to do it, and they will repeat the entire challenge. What it will lead to? Employees are getting benefited in various ways, which we'll discuss ahead. Next question comes, is it really feasible? Talking about the feasibility, here is a classic example of this individual. He works in a proper corporate, proper 9 to 6 job, but it's on the papers. But actually, it's 9 to 9 job. But still, when this individual started on this challenge, he was weighing 95 kgs. At the end of 3 weeks, he was 91.9 kgs. Muscle increased by 2 kgs and fat mass decreased by 5%. Isn't it a great thing which one can do to their own self? As we talk about the gain was reduced stress, reduced anxiety. There were improved eating habits. They started selecting a proper good and healthy foods. They started reading the labels. There was decreased risk of metabolic disorders. Absenteeism decreased, so the attendance increased. And there was improved self-confidence among the individuals, because they understood 30% of gym and 70% of diet is going to give them 100% results. As we all know, abs are not made inside the gym. They are made inside the kitchen. So it's very essential to kickstart your eating habits and your day-to-day physical activities from now. We understood that it's very essential to work on your own self. The transformation is essential. There should be you versus you. The competition should be between you to become an upgraded version of your own self. But now the excuse will come, which we give to our own selves on day in day out basis, that I don't have time. This time the excuse is there is a lockdown. How can I do transformation? Is it possible? I would suggest see it your own self. The results are here in front of you. It is very much possible, provided you give that determination and consistency towards your exercise and diet regime, and not to forget proper sleeping habits. It will give you a result, not immediately but definitely. Be consistent, be thorough with what you are determined for. There is a transformation, there is a challenge. It's you versus you to get better version of your own self. It's very essential to challenge yourself on day-to-day basis. Go for it. To sum it up, corporate employees are at higher risk of developing lifestyle disorders due to their day-to-day lifestyle and their addictions such as cigarette smoking, alcohol, too much of parties and whatnot kind of drugs. Therefore, health management is essential to have a balance between your work life and your personal life also. Apart from diet and exercise, sleep will play a major role in your weight management. Take up this 8 weeks of in-body transformation challenge, which will help you to develop a better version of your own self in a longer run. Thank you for being with us in this webinar today. If you have got any doubts or any questions regarding this webinar, or if you have got any doubts how you can incorporate this 8-week challenge in your day-to-day lifestyle, or if you have got any doubts regarding InBody devices, you can please DM us on Instagram or Facebook at InBody India. That's our Insta handle name or Facebook handle name. Or you can write an email to us at india@inbody.com. We are happy to help you. Thank you.